Hello guys. Welcome to this lecture. In this video, I am going to explain the concept of atomic orbitals. So as you all know, the atoms consist of a positively charged nucleus and negatively charged surrounding electrons. These electrons exist on different electron shells according to the energy levels of these electrons. Each shell can hold up to 2 multiplied by n squares, where n is an integer positive that indicates the shell order starting from 1, the nearest to the nucleus. The energy of an electron in a particular energy level is determined by its distance from the nucleus and the attractive force between the electron and the positively charged nucleus. The energy levels of electrons play a crucial role in determining the chemical and physical properties of an atom, including its reactivity, bonding behavior, and spectral characteristics. Electrons can move from one energy level to another by absorbing or emitting energy in the form of photons. When an electron absorbs energy, it moves to a higher energy level, and when it emits energy, it moves to a lower energy level. Electron shells, also known as energy level, are the regions of space around an atomic nucleus where electrons are likely to be found. They are characterized by their energy level, shape, and orientation in space. The electrons in an atom are distributed among different orbitals based on their energy levels. Each energy level corresponds to a set of orbitals with different shapes and orientations. The first energy level contains only one orbital, called the 1s orbital, while the second energy level contains 4 orbitals, a single 2s orbital, and 3 orbitals 2p. Whereas the third energy level has 9 orbitals, a single 3s orbital, 3 orbitals 3p, and 5 3d orbitals. Each electron in an atom occupies an atomic orbital with a unique set of quantum numbers that describe its energy, shape, and orientation. Number 1, principal quantum number, so-called n. This quantum number describes the energy level of the electron and the distance of the orbital from the nucleus. The larger n, the furthest from the nucleus. Number 2, angular momentum quantum number. Known as L, this quantum number describes the shape of the orbital and its angular momentum. Shapes are the regions in space where electrons can exist in. Whereas angular momentum is a physical quantity that describes the rotational motion of an object around an axis. The azimuthal quantum number will never be larger than the principal quantum number, and L can take on any value up to n-1. Number 3, the magnetic quantum number m. The magnetic quantum number determines the orientation of the atomic orbital in space relative to an external magnetic field. It can have integer values from minus L to plus L. For example, the m value for an s orbital is 0 because it has only one orientation. The m values for a p orbital are minus 1, 0, and 1 because it has 3 orientations. In case of d orbital, the m values are minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, and 2 because it has 5 orientations. Number 4, the electron spin quantum, which is an independent number, is of the values of n, l, and m. The value of this number gives insight into the direction in which the electron is spinning and is denoted by the symbol s of m. The value of S of M offers insight into the direction in which the electron is spinning. The possible values of the electron spin quantum number are plus 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2. The positive value of S of M implies an upward spin on the electron, which is also called spin up. If S of M has a negative value, the electron in question is said to have a downward spin or a spin down. In a nutshell, different energy levels are expressed by the number N around the nucleolus that increases by distance from the nucleus. Each of these has orbitals described by m. Each orbital can have different orientations in space relative to an external magnetic field, and represented by L of m. And lastly, each of these can hold up to 2 electrons that must spin in opposite directions to each other. There are 3 rules for construction of an orbital diagram of an atom. First, the Pauli exclusion principle. This principle states that no 2 identical electrons can occupy the same quantum state simultaneously. So in case of 2 electrons that share the same energy level or quantum number n, the same orbital, which means the same L value, and same quantum number m, these 2 electrons must be spinning in opposite directions to each other. Second, the Aufbau principle, which states that electrons fill lower energy atomic orbitals before filling higher energy ones. Which means that first 1s orbital is filled with 2 electrons before filling the 2s orbital and so on. This figure shows the order of orbitals from low to high energy. Third principle is Hund's rule, which states that there must be 1 electron with the same spin in each orbital of the same energy before you can put 2 in the same orbital. According to Hund's rule, if you have 4 electrons to be filled in a d orbital, this is not stable filling because electrons repel each other. But this one is stable. So, to figure out the electron configuration of sulfur as an example which has 16 electrons, we should follow the Aufbau principle to fill the atomic orbitals from lower to higher energy. In this case, 2 electrons go for 1s, 2 for 2s, 6 for 2p, and 2 for 3s, the remaining 4 electrons will exist in the 3p orbital. Firstly, one electron in each orbital of these three has the same spinning orientation. And the last one will exist in the first orbital according to Hund's rule but in the opposite spinning orientation. The electron configuration can be expressed as following: 1s power 2, 2s power 2, 2p power 6, 3s power 2, and 3p power 4. The numbers in black indicate the number of electrons in each subshell. As you all know, this is the periodic table. The periodic table is a tabular arrangement of chemical elements, organized based on their atomic number, electron configuration, and recurring chemical properties. In the periodic table, the elements are arranged in rows called periods and columns called groups. The periods represent the number of electron shells or the energy level in an atom, while the groups represent the number of valence electrons, electrons in the outermost shell, and often indicate similar chemical properties. Since the arrangement of the periodic table is based on the electron configurations, this figure provides an alternative method for determining the electron configuration. The filling order simply begins at hydrogen, which has only one electron on the 1s orbital. Then the following atom will have one electron more, and so on. The first period or row of the periodic table consists of elements that have their electrons filling the 1s orbital. The second period elements fill the 2s and 2p orbitals, while the third period elements fill the 3s, 3p, and 3d orbitals. This pattern continues throughout the periodic table, with each subsequent period adding new shells and subshells until the seventh period. That was everything for this video. Thank you for watching.